Welcome back to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. I'm Bob, and today I'm going to show you how to properly drill a pilot hole along with a countersink using a spade bit. So let's get started. Okay, so I have here two spade bits. I'm going to drill a pilot hole and a countersunk with these two spade bits. These are wood spade bits here. And I am going to drill for this 3/8 lag screw that I have here. I have my ratchet. So what's key here about the pilot hole, I'm sorry, about the countersunk hole, is that you need to have enough diameter to be able to use a ratchet to drive this lag screw in. So it's important that you get the right size. So for like a 3/8 hole, I mean a 3/8 lag screw, I'm using a 5/16 pilot hole. For a 9/16 socket, I'm using an 1¼ spade bit. Basically, to give me enough room that if this moves around, that I'm not tight, and it makes it very hard when it's tight to get the socket out. It becomes a real issue. Now I'm going to use a ratchet to put this in. There's many other things you can use, a pneumatic. They have some, you know, cordless drills that you can use today to install the lag. This is for demonstration purposes, so I'm just gonna do this. The first thing that you need to do and what not to do is you never drill your pilot hole first. If you drill your pilot hole, which I'm gonna demonstrate to you what happens, if you drill your pilot hole first, in other words, your 5/16 for the 3/8, okay? If you drill that first, when you go to drill your countersunk afterwards, this is gonna swash around inside and it's not gonna guide properly. So with a spade bit, this little diamond shaped blade point is what guides the drill bit and holds it in place. If you were to drill this hole with this spade bit for 5/16, it's just going to be too big, and this is going to jump around, it's going to jam the drill, and you possibly could hurt yourself. So I'm going to demonstrate this now. So I installed my spade bit into the drill, and I'm basically ready to do my countersunk hole. You always have to do your countersunk hole first for the head, and then how far you're going to go down. So basically, I'm going to countersink approximately, I would say to you, about 3/4 of an inch to 1 inch into this wood. Okay. So now I have enough where I've gone down about 3/4 of an inch, which will be a nice countersink. I'm going to switch out my bit, and now I'm going to put my pilot hole bit in. Tighten that up, and now I'm going to put this in, and as you continue drilling, well, until I get through the other side. Always back up to bring the wood shavings. Well, that didn't work great, huh? I guess I didn't tighten it enough. So, just tighten it up. Okay. Then I'm gonna take my ratchet and I drive it in. And there you go. That's done. Now I'm going to demonstrate for you if I was to drill my pilot hole first. Now this is not a big pilot hole, but if you were using a larger size, let's say half inch, it's going to be more severe. So I'm going to drill the pilot hole first. But you can see this very nicely drilled through with no problem. I'm going to switch out my bit to do my countersunk. So, as you can see here, this now will wobble around. And with that wobbling around, you're not going to get a totally centered countersunk. It's going to want to take off. So I'm going to have to be cautious. If I go too fast, it's going to jump around on me, and it may wedge the bit in the hole and start to twist it in my arm. And I don't want to do that. You can see already, just by what I just did, how this is chewing away at the wood, which is not what we're looking for. You see how that's jumping around? You can do it. You can get the countersunk done, but it's not precise. It's not clean. It doesn't give you a nice clean finish. So at the end of the day, you really want to drill your countersunk first and then your pilot hole. Another thing to do if you wanted to stop the splintering is to put some glue tape over the area that you're going to drill, which is very good for marking. You can write on blue tape. Let me just find the beginning of this tape here. There it is. Okay. So another thing you could do is just go over. This will stop splintering from happening when you're using a spade bit. So I'm going to do another countersunk. And that gives you a nice clean surface. As you see how nice and smooth that cut. Now, these bits I've used already before I'm doing this demonstration. So these are not brand new bits. Brand new bits, you would have a nice sharper bit. And then you can see how nice I could drill through here. And then you can pull this off, the tape, and there you go. That's how you properly drill a countersunk with your pilot hole drill bits. Thanks for watching.
Congratulations to Randall E. of Kodiak, Alaska. He is our Cool Creations winner for this week. Randall has created all-terrain undercarriage guards for use on ATVs and other recreational vehicles. Randall is using our flat socket cap screws in stainless steel and our stainless finishing cup washers for a sleek finished look on his GrizTech armor-plated guards. GrizTech offers great protection from rocks, mud, sticks, and debris that can foul the fan or cause damage to the radiator and undercarriage of the ATV. Thanks again for submitting your cool creations, Randall. We appreciate you, and thanks for watching. See you next week.